Welcome back, everybody. It is the morning of November 3rd, and I'm going to get in a few hours sit before I got to get to work, but it's an absolutely beautiful morning out here. We have a wind right out of the northwest. I'm hunting this ridge top that's deep in the hardwoods down here for that buck that I call Hulk. I actually cut a few really big fresh tracks on my way down in here that were within the last few hours. Running this ridge side right here. So I'm looking forward to seeing what happens this morning. The woods is absolutely gorgeous. We got a bunch of, you know, a layer of snow, and finally the wind's died down. The snow is super crunchy, so even with me being half deaf, I should be able to hear something coming. They shouldn't sneak up on me. There's nowhere else I'd rather be right now than right here, that's for sure. Hopefully a big boy comes through this morning. You gotta just take a second, everybody. Soak this in for a second. You know, the feeling that overcomes my hair is freaking crazy. I don't care. The feeling that overcomes you when you send an arrow through a mature buck, when you work so hard to do that, is almost, you know, it's what I live for. I said it before, but I live for this. I mean, I wake up and go to bed thinking about this. And Kaylee, of course. And when it comes together, when you pick the right tree, you do everything right, you make a good shot. You know, this is what it's about. This is what life's about. This is what it's about for me. You know, it's a really crazy feeling when you send an arrow through a deer like that, because I'm like so happy, but at the same time, I'm a little sad. I think I know that buck. It's a 3.5-year-old 8-point. I've got tons of pictures of him the last 2 years. Oh, it's a nice buck. Probably 18 inches wide, I'd say. It was definitely one that, you know, I was in here after. It's not Hulk, but it's a really nice buck. And it worked out perfect. This morning I took Doe and Heat pea from Wyoming County Whitetail and poured it all over my boots, and then I poured it all around the base of my tree. And if you notice where that buck was, he was sniffing that Doe and Heat right on my boot track right there. Actually, there's my arrow. Jeez, look at the blood. Look at the blood trail up through there. At this point, you just sit here and reflect on, you know, the countless hours I put into this hunting season. That huge brassica food plot that's planted about 400 yards to my left, and all the stands that, you know, you work on, and making the habitat what it needs to be to hold big bucks, and only hunting the right wind and staying out of the spots like this until it's right. And when it all comes together, it's just a feeling like none other. It really is. Like, I can't stress it to you enough. If you're a non-hunter and for some reason you're watching this and you don't hunt, man, you gotta try it. It's something that, it puts you in a place that's really good. That's all I have to say. But I'm just gonna sit here for a while and soak this in, and then we'll go down and check them out. We'll go ahead and FaceTime Monty and see what he's up to. I bet he knows when phone call comes at 7:30 in the morning what it's going to be about.
Yeet. You get it done?
He's dead. It's not Hulk, but it's really good deer. You know which one it is, not Crabby. It's the freaking, remember that big 8-point that came through like late rifle season when we checked his camera over here? That wide 8-point is a young buck last year. Remember?
Oh, yeah.
It's that buck. He's probably, I bet you he's a little over 18 inches wide. Just a really nice 8-point. I did did a scent drag with my boots this morning. I put Doe and Heat asterisk on my boots, and I walked right down this trail right here. See my boot tracks right there? That buck came right up sniffing and smelled that Doe and Heat, and I shot him right there. Ran about 60 yards over there and fell over dead.
Here at the upper farm?
Yep. Yep. It's a freaking beautiful morning out here, my gosh.
Oh, I knew this morning had to be it. I was looking at the weather.
Yeah, it's
Griffin. Hey, wake up, Uncle about a buck.
Griffin. Griffin. Hey, hey Griffin. Good morning, Griff. Hey, Griff. Good morning, buddy.
Oh, yeah.
I got a big buck, Griffin. I'll send you a picture here in a little bit, Monty.
Yeah, okay. You get good video of it?
Perfect.
Nice.
I had him right... Had him right here. I had cameras going. And...
Well, that's good. I'll be looking forward to the picture.
Okay, Monty. Have a good day. Bye.
Yeah, you too.
We'll give Kaylee a call and let her know.
Hello?
Hey, babe.
Did you just shoot a big buck?
Yep, I did.
Well, that's exciting.
Yep, it's a good one.
What, do you know which one it was?
Yeah, it's that really wide 8-point. Upper farm there. It's
the new one, or
it's he's been here, but he is. I don't have that many pictures of him, but it's a really nice one.
Good job. Today is a perfect morning.
Yeah, it was. Sitting here is like, man, it don't get any better. You know, November 3rd, snow on the cold, and just everything's perfect. I wanted to show you guys my setup here. I've gotten lots of questions on my channel about my camera setup and even my tree stand setup and stuff. So I'm 99% of the time hunting out of this Summit Climber. I have a few different ones. This one I just got from my buddy and trying it out, and it's absolutely awesome. These things are incredibly safe and they lock right on the tree, easy to go up and down. This bar in the front, you know, holds you right in, and these climbers, I just can't say enough good things about them. My camera arm is actually just a Realtree easy hanger, and I have a little muddy camera mount on it. You know, it's a super cheap setup. I went and bought, you know, the fancy muddy camera arm that you have to ratchet strap to the tree, and to be honest with you, it was just a lot to carry and it was a pain in the ass to use, you know, and you made all that racket with the ratchet, and honestly I couldn't get. It was just a pain. You know, this is the easiest thing to do. I can put this easy hanger right in my backpack with my camera, get to the tree, screw it in, bam, works great. And I get super, super smooth, good motion video with this easy hanger. You know, it pivots in multiple spots, super easy to use. You know, you loosen it, go up and down, quiet. Always have my backpack that I hang right off the easy hanger. Have my Wyoming County Whitetail Doe and Heat urine. And I have a bottle of buck urine that I put in the scrape up there. That actually I had a little buck hit that hanging vine scrape that I freshened. And then I have my GoPro mount above me so I can swing that, you know, whichever way. I have a deer coming really easily, so if I can't get it with the main camera, I can get it with a GoPro. And I have my rangefinder hung right off that so I can use that easily in my grunt call. And then I have another easy hanger that I hang my bow up with. So that's my whole setup for anybody that was questioning my setup. Let's get down and track this buck down. Yeet. Okay, this is where I came down through. That buck was literally right on my track, sniffing that doe and heat urine. There's his track walking right down it. Here is impact of the arrow. Like the end of it broke right off. Must be stuck in the offside shoulder.
shooting a Rage 2 blade. Tell you, blood trail is not hard in the snow. Man, look at all the blood coming out of him there. There he is. Awesome.
Well, here he is, everybody. He only ran probably 60 yards and crashed over here. I must be stuck that arrow right in the offside shoulder. But it's a huge body deer, and I have a lot of pictures of this buck last year right up here on the food plot, and I have some video of him this year. I couldn't be any happier. It's certainly not Hulk or, you know, the Bully 8 by any means, but, you know, it's a really solid buck, and, you know, I couldn't be any happier. I have so much fun doing this stuff, and, you know, this is what it's all about. So, I got to get a tag on him, get him gutted out, and then I'm going to go get the gator and get him out of here. Awesome. Okay, we got the buck all loaded up. Now we get to go show it off. I'll go show my grandparents, my parents, see if Abby and Levi are home, show them what a buck looks like, even though I bet their dad will be showing them one soon.
Four, five, 10 points?
Eight.
Nine.
8 points.
8 points. Nice.
Yep.
Perfect shot, huh?
Yeah, that. I'm gonna have to watch the video. I wasn't aiming right there. I don't know. I was aiming behind the shoulder and I hit in front of the shoulder somehow. So I don't know.
Know what happened.
Know what happened with that, but.
He must have backed up.
I don't know. Put one heck of a hole in him, though.
Yeah. Good. What time did you just get it? Or?
I shot at 7:30 this morning.
Mm-hmm. That's good.
Yep, it's a big body deer. I'm going to weigh him when I get back, but.
Mm-hmm. Where was the coyote?
The coyote was behind the house last night. I heard him howling out there, and I got the my gun out, and sure enough, there he was going across the field. It's actually a female.
Huh.
And shot her. Made a heck of a shot. She was about 360 yards back in Brian's cornfield.
Hey, you got one, huh?
Yep, finally. It wasn't the big one up there, but I couldn't let it go by me. I was pretty excited with it.
Yeah.
It's actually a buck that I know pretty well from last year. I got a bunch of trail camera pictures of him, and his rack really didn't change much.
Huh.
It's a little bigger than he was last year, but very similar.
Yeah.
And then I shot this coyote last night behind the house. I heard it howling out there, and sure enough, it was in Brian's cornfield, and I shot it at 360 yards last night. Hit it right here behind the shoulder. I actually held a little bit above it.
Hello.
Mm-hmm. It's hoping I was going to catch Uncle John this morning. We got him here, Grandpa.
Hey, there he is.
Oh, you got a fox too, or a coyote too?
Yep.
Where'd you get that?
Right behind the house, running across Brian's cornfield last night.
Oh, jeez. Man, you put a big freaking hole in him, didn't you?
Yeah, I did.
And this was up the upper farm?
Oh, yep.
Oh, look at that.
What do you think, Grandma?
What a morning, Cliff.
That's beautiful.
Holy cow.
That's a nice one.
It's not the big one I was after, but boy, I couldn't let him go by when he...
No, I wouldn't either.
How did this happen?
He was howling out behind the house last night, and I got the gun out and scope out and looked back there, and there he was about 360 yards out into Brian's cornfield and held a little bit over his back.
He let out his
last hole. Yep.
Where'd you hit him at?
Right behind the shoulder. I shot him with a 6.5 Creedmoor.
God, he's in good shape.
Yeah, it's
well,
actually
not
a...
Now, but he
it was actually a female. And then there was another one with it. After I shot that one, another one took off across the field. And it never stopped. I should have howled or did something to try to get it to stop, but he didn't stop.
They smarten up pretty quick.
Yeah, they do.
That's
yeah,
a good shot.
Yeah, it was.
You could see him in the scope.
Well, I have a night vision scope. It was at night, so.
Can I use that when deer season?
Nope, I don't think you can, Grandpa.
Well, you really put the meat to that sucker.
Yeah.
Going in or coming out?
That was going in. I'm kind of confused. I thought I hit him. I haven't watched the video yet, but when I shot him, I was aiming right here. I don't know how it hit up there, unless it was quartered way more.
He might have moved.
The arrow was stuck in his offside shoulder, so it might have been quartered to me just a little bit.
Nothing else, you give him a bloody nose.
How far away was he, Cliff, when you shot him?
20 yards.
Oh, right under your tree.
Yep, he was right there. I actually...
Come check it out, huh?
Guess what I got, Levi?
Levi, what do you get?
What is it, Abigail?
What do you see?
Oh.
Oh my goodness. Two for one deal, huh?
What is it? Look.
What's that, Levi?
What is it?
What is it, a buck?
What's a buck say?
Yeah.
You get both of these this morning?
I got the coyote last night and the buck this morning.
Jeepers.
I was kind of weak on that buck. The camera had everything perfect and I just...
Yeah, you
I
went
did it.
For it.
Yeah, I did it and you can't take it back
now.
That's friend.
Okay, we got the coyote on the scale and that weighs in at 32.40 pounds. 32 pound female. Let's get my buck hung up and see what he's gonna weigh in at. Okay, our scale's all zeroed out and we got his legs hooked up. Now we're gonna have to figure out how to do that. Put the camera down. At 146.5, it looks like. 146. I just leaned that coyote up against the tree. I want to see what our dog does when I let her out with that coyote standing next to the tree like that. Scout! Come here, Scout! I'm gonna go ahead and wrap this video up right now, everybody. I want to thank everybody for watching, and I really want to thank, you know, everybody that's been following me along throughout the hunting season on the vlog style videos that I've been posting. I've been posting a video literally every time I hunt. You guys know within hopefully 24 hours how the hunt went through the vlog that I post. If you guys enjoy that, the way I'm doing that, make sure you let me know in the comment section. If you'd rather just see the hunts that I'm successful and I kill a deer or we kill a deer, let me know in that in the comments as well. But I really want to thank all the patrons of the channel, and I want to show you guys some t-shirts that we have that we're selling on the channel. If you guys want to help support us, we got camouflage KEO hats, then we have these black hats. And Kaylee, what's the price on the hats?
$15.
And the t-shirt?
$16.
And what sizes do we have?
All sizes.
All sizes. And I'll show you what the, this is the back of the shirt. It's just a, our logo. And then the front is, well, actually I'm wearing one, I think.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
I sure am. That's what they look like. So, if you guys have any questions about anything, any of my equipment or, anything like that, just leave me a comment about it, and, I'll get back to you as soon as I can. I'll try to reply to everybody with any questions. And I just want to thank everybody, and I really appreciate all the support you guys are giving Kaylee and I right here on our YouTube channel. It means a lot to us, and I enjoy you know, sharing my experiences in the woods, especially when people, you know, get excitement through the videos as well. So thanks, and there's a lot more to come. I've got Pennsylvania tags, so I'll be bow hunting for a buck in Pennsylvania the next couple weeks, and I've still got doe tags here in New York, so I'd like to fill a doe tag with my recurve if I can, so I can get out after that. Kaylee's got, obviously, tags. Crossbow starts on the 7th here in New York, and at that point, my dad will get out, and I'll go videotape him, hopefully kill a buck. So we got lots more stuff coming on the channel, and I really appreciate, you know, everybody watching. So we'll see you soon. Lots more to come. This is just the beginning of hunting season, really. I mean, there's a lot of hunting left, and it's going to get even better. So hope your season's going good. Go ahead and leave a comment and tell me how your season's going, and hopefully it's going as good as mine. If it's not, there's good luck to come. Take it easy, everybody.